Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
In some fantastic public health news today, the entire continent of Africa, with the 47 nations of the World Health Organization's Africa region, is to be declared free of wild polio. The declaration comes 4 years after the continent reported its last case of wild poliovirus in Nigeria and 24 years after the launch of the international polio eradication campaign here. In this video, we'll talk about polio the disease, the polio virus, the fight for vaccine eradication and eradication drives, and what exactly wild polio is. My name is Sandhya Ramesh and this is Pure Science. Polio is short for poliomyelitis, which is an infectious disease caused by the polio virus. Polio has existed since prehistory. It has been shown in historic art, including being depicted in Egyptian paintings. It was medically first documented well in the late 1700s itself. Polio spreads through feces and fecal matter entering the mouth through infected food or water. As living conditions and sanitation improved in the Western world, especially with colonization, polio began to drastically come down among children. It did remain more prevalent in low and middle income countries, especially those with poor hygiene and sanitation. Through the 20th century, there were only a few small localized outbreaks throughout the world, which then started to go up in the second half of the 1900s. The disease is present and naturally infects only the human population. Other animals, especially primates, can be infected in the lab, but naturally it occurs only among humans. It manifests as problems with mobility. There is muscle weakness in multiple parts of the body in the disease, resulting in loss of mobility or inability to move. About 25% of the people infected with the disease die, but most recover. Just like COVID, a majority are asymptomatic, some have mild symptoms, and some people may even require therapy post-recovery. Even asymptomatic people can be infectious, and in the case of polio, for up to 6 weeks, but the disease is already preventable with multiple doses of the existing polio vaccine. Rosalind Franklin, the chemist who discovered the structure of the DNA, was the same person who also discovered the structure of the polio virus as well. There are three serotypes of wild polio viruses, which occur naturally, and these three differ in their capsid protein structures. These are the polioviruses 1, 2, and 3. Poliovirus 2 and 3 are eradicated today. 2 was eradicated in September of 2015, and poliovirus 3 was just eradicated last year in 2019. Poliovirus 1 still remains. Now, when we talk about polio, and even in this case, when we talk about the eradication of wild polio in the African continent, we are talking about polio that occurs naturally and infects the human population naturally. Because in contrast, in some very, very rare cases, people have been infected with polio through the vaccination itself. And that virus is not wild polio, it's live attenuated modified poliovirus. However, there still persists polio infections by vaccination even in parts of Africa, and this is called vaccine-derived polio, which still poses a threat to our population. There are two kinds of polio vaccines, the inactivated vaccine that's given as an injection and the live attenuated version, which is administered as oral drops, because remember, polio is transmitted through the oral route. Oral polio vaccine, or OPV, is more effective than injected or IPV. The immunity it provides seems to be more long-lasting and covers all three serotypes, poliovirus 1, 2, and 3. 3 doses produces antibodies in about 95% of the people who are given these doses, and it also produces a good immune response to intestinal infections as well. Immunity from OPV is thought to be lifelong. We've seen in detail in other videos how vaccines work. Our bodies recognize the antigen as being a foreign invader and mount an immune response to it. Adaptive immune response kicks in later stages, and the memory of the antigen is stored in our immune system. Anytime this antigen comes into the body again, the immune system will quickly and precisely fire again after it recognizes the virus, and thus it prevents an infection and thus offers a lifelong immunity. The very first polio vaccine attempts were made in the 1930s. There were many hits and misses, primarily misses where children who had been given the vaccination died. But finally, in 1948 came a breakthrough where researchers were able to successfully cultivate the virus in human tissue in the lab. This even got the team the Nobel Prize in 1954 for medicine. Later, the first commercially marketable vaccine was the injection one that was developed by Jonas Salk, an American virologist, in 1952. The development of this polio vaccine is what started the first ever effective mass vaccination drives in an organized manner. Then, about 10 years later, the oral polio vaccine came into use. In 1998, an international effort to wipe out the disease began, headed by WHO, and wild polio began to be eliminated bit by bit in each country. India was declared polio-free in March of 2014. However, the oral polio vaccine is also thought to either mutate very rapidly or be at a higher risk of causing infections, and thus we hope to discontinue its use as soon as possible to prevent vaccine-driven infections. Poliovirus 1 now only remains in the wild in some local regions in Pakistan and Afghanistan, where there has been resistance to the vaccine, primarily because people wrongly but widely believe in the conspiracy theory that the vaccine is a ploy to sterilize male children. Once this area is also rid of the wild poliovirus, we will wait and watch a few years to ensure there are no new cases, and then we can declare the world is free of wild polio. Once we then tackle vaccine-derived polio cases, polio will then go on to become the second disease in humans after smallpox that we have successfully eradicated with a vaccine. Today's video again is on wildfires and focusing again on California, which is seeing some terrifying real-world effects of global climate change. At the moment, the state, which is no stranger to regular wildfires, is seeing two of its biggest ever forest fires since 1932. There is weather warning out as well for the unusual phenomenon of dry lightning. Additionally, there are two hurricanes approaching the country from the other side simultaneously, as pictures of more than five simultaneous waterspouts or tornadoes overseas are also going viral. In this video, we're going to talk about an assorted combination of forest fires, dry lightning, heat waves.